Hello students, chapter 3, plant kingdom. In this is video number 6, and in this we are going to study about the plant life cycle and alternation of generation. Now whenever there is a life, as plants are sexually reproducing, then in plants you always see that the haploid gametophyte and the spore producing diploid sporophyte stages are alternating with each other. This is known as alternation of generation. So there are three types of alternation of generation. First is haplontic life cycle. In haplontic life cycle, the major part of the life cycle is haploid. The dominant photosynthetic phase of the plant is represented by free living gametophyte. The sporophyte over here in this diagram is represented by this blue region. The sporophytic generation is represented only by one celled zygote. So it is a very short stage. The zygote undergoes meiosis to form haploid spores, and again the haploid gametophytic plant generation starts. This type of life cycle you can see in Volvox and Spirogyra and some species of Chlamydomonas. The second life cycle is diplontic life cycle. In the diplontic life cycle, the main plant body is diploid. That is, the sporophyte is dominant. It is the photosynthetic phase of the plant. And the gametophytic part is represented only by the gametes. So it is a small phase where the gametes are dependent upon the sporophyte. This you can see in gymnosperms and angiosperms. The third life cycle is the haplodiplontic life cycle. This involves the sequential reoccurrence of the two developed phases. Both the phases, the gametophyte and the sporophyte, are well developed and it alternates with each other. You see this type of life cycle in bryophyte and pteridophyte. Only difference in bryophyte and pteridophyte is that in bryophyte, the dominant phase is the gametophytic phase, which is independent, and the sporophyte is totally dependent on the gametophyte. Whereas in pteridophyte, the dominant independent phase is sporophyte, which alternates with gametophyte, and here the gametophytic phase is also independent. So in haplodiplontic life cycle, both the phases, the gametophytic as well as the sporophytic phase, is well developed and has equal lifespan in the whole life cycle. Now let us talk about the different classification system. The different classification system can be artificial, natural, or phylogenetic. Artificial classification system was given by Linnaeus. Natural was given by Bentham Hooker and phylogenetic by Hutchinson. Talking about artificial classification system, it was the earliest system of classification and it used only gross morphological characters like habit, color, number, and shape of leaves. It also was based on the vegetative characters. The biggest disadvantage of this artificial system of classification was that it separated the closely related species because it was based on only few characteristics, and it gave equal weightage to vegetative as well as sexual characters. And we know today that vegetative characters are easily affected by the environment. Still, it gave equal weightage to vegetative as well as sexual characters. Then came the natural system of classification. The natural system of classification is based on not only on external features, but also on internal features like ultrastructure, anatomy, embryology. So it takes more characters into consideration. phylogenetic system of classification, it is based on evolutionary relationship between various organisms, and it says that organism belonging to the same taxa have a common ancestor. Nowadays, the taxonomy takes into consideration numerical taxonomy, that is, it takes into consideration computers. All observable characteristics are based on computers. Numbers and codes are assigned to these characters, and then the data is processed. All characters are given equal importance, and hundreds of characters can be considered at a time. Then there is another type of taxonomy known as cytotaxonomy, that is based on cytological information. What do you mean by cytological information? That is chromosome number, structure of chromosome, and behavior of chromosome. And last, chemotaxonomy. This type of taxonomy is based on chemical constituents of an organism, like the taxonomy or the classification is based on amino acids, proteins, DNA sequences, that makes up the chemical constituent of an organism. Children, chemical constituent of plants are very specific and stable. So this type of classification is a lot considered in plants. So this finishes with chapter 3, and go through the video. Thank you.